day I was walking alone until I reached a forest. There was a fork in the trail. To my left, a narrow path, which seemed rugged and far too skinny. To my right, a broad path, which looked soft and filled with sand and flowers. I contemplated and contemplated and contemplated. I saw four travelers dancing along this path. Don't go down that harsh road. Come with me if you'd like some fresh pastries. Sit in the shade with us at the end, and all your worries will be gone. Don't you know everyone goes down this road? It's a piece of cake, they said. The cares of this world plague my very thoughts. Bills, friends who use you, family issues, life is too hard. The desire for pleasure is pulling me down this path. I want nice things. Why can't I have nice things? As I listened carefully, I noticed I could hear wailing in the distance, faint cries for help. I immediately felt dread, terror, a fear I have never felt before. The four hikers were so blinded by the good things that they did not care where their path ended. This road was a lie, a trap that led to destruction. Now the narrow path, I could see what seemed like dried up blood, sweat, and tears on the ground, thorns and thistles, jagged rocks, up, down, and all throughout. It seemed very painful, excruciating. I've been walking on thorns my entire life. Do I really want to go on in pain? But as I looked closer, at the end of this road, I could see a brilliant light, a being in the shape of a man. To my surprise, he spoke.
I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. Choose you this day whom you will serve.
I felt an overwhelming sense of joy, peace, and warmth awaiting anyone who endures down this road. When I heard those words, I felt as if I were to choose him, choose this path, he would be the source of my strength. He would lead me all the way through to the other side. I'm tired of serving my flesh. I'm tired of trying to satisfy a lust that can't be satisfied. I'm tired of living as if someday I won't stand before the creator of all things. I'm tired of doing everything I want to do. Lord, let me do what you want me to do. I've been living recklessly as if I want to die. But the truth is, I don't want to die. I want to live. For wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leads to destruction, and many there be which go in thereat. Because straight is the gate, and narrow is the way which leads unto life, and few there be that find it. Which road will you take?